Alright, hey guys, Cossack Ray here. Today I'm going to be bringing you another video on making potions, except this time I'm going to get a little bit more in depth. I'm going to show you guys some of the different ingredients that you use to make potions, some of the different potions you can make, meaning what you use to make them and their effects, and all that good stuff. So once again, guys, we're on my mystical island. Nothing much has changed except, I guess, there's a fire there. And, you know, just random stuff over there. Anyway, let's get on with the video. So, first off, I'll go over the basic ingredients of what you use to make potions. So, the first basic thing that you need for every potion is a glass bottle. I've said that before. And the main ingredients that add special effects to regular potions are the fermented spider eye. This stuff gives negative effects and downgrades upgraded effects, so this is more used for maybe making, you know, sabotage type potions. I'm not entirely sure. That's what makes this potion a weakness here. And then we got glowstone dust. This upgrades effects, so say you have the basic speed potion, it would make it go even faster, but then it decreases the duration, and that's what happened here. This is the normal one. It got faster, but it decreased the speed by half. We have netherward. This is a neutral base for regular potions, so this is just to make, you know, your basic awkward potion, and we'll talk about that later. And then we have redstone dust. This increases the duration of effects, but it downgrades upgraded effects. So it would make you run faster for longer, but we wouldn't run as fast as you normally would. And then these next ingredients are for making advanced potions, so ones that will actually give you effects. And first off, we have blaze powder. This is used for strength. Ghast tears are for health. Magma cream is for fire resistance. Spider eyes are for poisoning. And sugar is for speed. So, pretty simple. I'm trying to keep it as simple as possible because it can get kind of complicated. So, first off, let's create your basic awkward potion, which is a base for most things. So let's add in these water bottles to our brewing stand. Okay, and so to make a awkward potion, we need to have netherwort. And we put that into the brewing stand. And remember, guys, you only need one ingredient to make three potions to fill those up completely, so that's pretty nice. And we're waiting here for this meter to fill up. And so what this is going to make is going to make the awkward potion, and from this we're going to build up on it so we can make advanced potions. So in 1 second here, it will be done brewing. And here we go. We got awkward potion, guys. No effects. And so now what we do to add to these potions and make it more advanced, like this potion of healing, potion of weakness, and potion of swiftness, is we have to add some of these more advanced ingredients, which are in this row. So say I want to make one for added strength, I'd add blaze powder. And as we can see, we are brewing away at our potions. And notice that before, if I had tried to put something you use to make advanced potions into it before I have a base potion, it wouldn't work. That's why you have to start out with some type of base potion, and that's what we have, the awkward potion. And really quickly, guys, the potion of healing, I used the awkward potion base and then added ghast tears. And for the weakness, I added, I believe it was fermented spider eyes. And for potion of swiftness, that was sugar. But anyway, here we go, guys. You got the potion of strength, which lasts for 3 minutes. And right now, I'll show you what you can do on top of this. And right now, I'm adding redstone, and this is going to increase the duration, but decrease the upgraded effects. So, we will be stronger for longer, but not quite as strong, I guess. So there's a lot of give and take with this stuff. It all depends on what you want to do. Remember, these potions last for 3 minutes regularly. So let's see, almost done, and here we go. 8 minutes, guys. That's what you get when you add redstone to it. Now let's try that with some glowstone. Done, and here we go. strength 2, and this cut its duration by half, but we're going to be stronger now. So I'll show you guys what this stuff is like when we drink it. So first, let's drink this. What is this one? This is the potion of strength that's been added to. So here we go. Probably in creative mode, you can't quite see it too much, but you know, there's an effect there. And the potion of swiftness. Let's drink this. And so as you can see, I'm actually running a lot faster, guys. This is pretty cool. That's all for this video, guys. I hope you really enjoyed it. It can get a little bit complicated, but when you break it down, it's pretty simple. You start out with your base potion ingredients, and then you can add on to that to make more advanced ones for health, strength, all that good stuff. And then you can add on top of that to add increased effects or increased duration. So, thanks for watching, guys. Remember to like, subscribe if you want to catch more of these videos I'll be uploading. And see you later, guys.